And now let's learn about another position value. This one is called absolute. Another way of modifying the position of an element is by setting its position to absolute. When an element's position is set to absolute, all other elements on the page will ignore the element and act like it is not present on the page. The element will be positioned relative to its closest positioned parent element. In the example above, the box button element div element will be moved down and right from the top left corner of the view. If offset properties weren't specified, the top box would be entirely covered by the bottom box. Take a look at the GIF below. And right here, the bottom box in the image, colored blue, this one, is displaced from the top left corner of its container. It is 20 pixels lower and 50 pixels to the right of the top box. In the next exercise, we will compare the scrolling of absolute elements with fixed elements. And as you can see, the blue box is now overlapping this first box, and that's because we set the position to absolute for the blue box, of course. In the style.css, set the position inside of the header selector to absolute. So right here, position absolute. Scroll up and down the web page. What do you notice? Let's first update our code. Now our header is positioned absolute, and because we didn't set the offsets, it is by default 0 left and 0 top. That's why it is positioned in the left corner, and everything else that comes after the header element is now behaving like the header element is not on the page. When you change the position to absolute, you may have noticed that the header shrunk horizontally. We will learn why in a later exercise. For now, set the width property of the header to 100%. So in order to have a full width header, we need to set 100% now, because it is positioned absolute. And now it is full width. Okay, let's proceed to the next exercise.